Do you struggle with latency between your application tiers? Proximity placement groups now make it possible for you to co-locate your virtual machines to achieve minimal latency. Ziv is here to show us how it works today on Azure Friday. Hey everyone, Donovan Brown here with another episode of Azure Friday. I'm here with Ziv and we're going to learn about proximity placement groups. So what is a proximity placement group and why do I care?
So to begin with, if you moved your applications to Azure, enterprise applications on multiple tiers, you have an application tier and a database tier. In Azure, you basically are trying to put them together to get the best latency, right?
Right.
It's not that easy. Why? Because multiple deployments in a single region may span multiple data centers. Even availability zones actually may span multiple data centers.
Right.
Even scale set and in the future availability sets may span multiple data centers. So what do? How do you put them together? Because you want to get the best latency. This is why we are thrilled to introduce proximity placement groups,
okay,
or from there on, PPG.
Okay.
It's a new construct in Azure. It's an ARM resource enabling you to co-locate your multiple compute resources. Today, we support only infrastructure as a service resources,
okay,
in the same data center to get the best latency.
Gotcha.
So you can take your virtual machines, either in or not using availability sets. You can take multiple scale sets and put them all inside one PPG or one proximity placement group to get the best latency possible or available today in Azure.
Gotcha. So it's really just a logical construct that says anything that I assign to this PPG, make sure that they're extremely close to each other.
Correct.
So that I can minimize my latency between the network communication.
Correct. Exactly. Right. Yes.
Got it.
And you can use multiple SKUs. You're using your application, you're using it with GPUs and the database running regular VMs. You're using bare metal for large instance of SAP HANA, for example,
okay,
and you want your application servers to be co-located, whatever goes.
Gotcha.
As long as it is infrastructure as a service today.
Today, right. So eventually I'll be able to have different types of resources co-located as well, such that between my app service and my database, just as well as between my database and my IaaS, is still going to be fast.
Correct. All that right, is our roadmap.
North Star.
Okay. Yes. So we just announced a public preview.
Okay.
For infrastructure as a service only, available in almost all regions. And we want to see a demo?
Yes, I'd love to see how it works.
Before that, just we have introduced, so I mentioned it's a new resource in ARM.
Yes.
So you need to start by creating it. You can use either ARM template, CLI, or PowerShell.
Okay.
We are not yet there in the portal.
Interesting.
Again, still preview. And you create this proximity placement group object. And then you use it when you create your availability set or VM or scale set.
Gotcha. So, okay, so show us an example, because here I see you in an ARM template, and I see that there's, okay, got it. So right under properties, there's the proximity placement group.
Yep.
And that's where I'm assigning the resource that I either provision before this ARM template or as part of this ARM template as, this is where I want you to put all the resources that
correct,
I
correct.
Got it. Okay, yes, cool. And we can do this, you said, from the CLI as well.
Let's give it a try.
Cool.
So I just created a new resource group. And I will try and create my placement group.
Okay.
So it's a PPG.
Got it.
Create, providing the region and the resource group. I just created it. And then I will pick up the ID from this newly created PPG.
Okay. So with that IP, then you'll be able to...
You can see PPG ID. This is how it looked like.
Okay.
And then when I create, for example, an availability set, I have one more parameter. You see it's kind of a PPG ID.
Gotcha.
You can see it in the script here.
And as I start to add additional resources, is there any limit to the number of resources I can assign to a PPG?
No.
Okay,
no limit. The only limit is the physical capacity of the data center.
Gotcha.
In other words, if you have 10,000 VMs, probably PPG is not for you.
Oh, interesting. Gotcha. And that's simply because trying to find that many in a region or in a data center, not a region, right?
It's
that's
a
very
data
specific,
center,
right? It's a data
a
center.
Yes.
Because a region is actually made up of multiple data centers, and I want to be in one data center so
correct,
that I'm as network close as possible.
Correct.
Got it. Okay, good.
Now, while it runs, I want to flip, or actually, just
too fast, man.
You know,
it's done already.
I just want to highlight one interesting aspect. So often you use multiple SKUs within your PPG. You have the backend running a very large instance, like an MV2 VM.
Okay.
You have your application maybe running some sort of an exotic VM, like one of the latest GPUs. And those may not be available in all the data centers, in the region.
Yeah.
So if you start with your application tier, let's say it's a DV3, which is available almost everywhere, and then you use PPG, and then you follow with the MV2, you may fail because I cannot have it. I don't have it, the MV2, in the same data center. So the recommendation in that case is to start with the more what you call exotic SKUs. Usually it's the largest, the more expensive, the one which you may think that we don't have them worldwide or in any of the data centers.
Gotcha.
And in case you see an error, the error that you'll see is an oversubscribed allocation request, then simply stop the allocate your VMs and try in a reverse order. Just change the sequence of your deployment and we'll do the right thing for you. Okay, or so use ARM template where you can put them all together and we will take it from there.
But even if I place it in an ARM template, if that region simply does not have the capacity, my ARM template will fail.
Correct.
But
yes.
I still like your idea of start with the biggest thing first, because you don't want to provision all these other resources just to find out that the heavy hitter that you want is not available and
exactly.
Then you fail. Try the biggest thing first, and if that succeeds, chances are all this little stuff is going to succeed with
yep.
it as well. Got it.
Yep.
All right, perfect.
Few more tips. Always, in this case, if latency is an issue for you, just make sure you're using accelerated networking.
Okay.
I think today it's the default for almost all VM sizes.
Okay.
And look, we have a documentation of how to optimize your network throughput for Azure Virtual Machines. And know what you're measuring. Okay. If you're looking for latency, we have documented a tool to measure latency. Don't try to copy whatever 100 GB and you know look for it, because you're not really testing latency.
Oh,
you're
very
testing
good point.
Many other things. You're testing throughput, you're testing the bandwidth,
disk speed, potentially all
speed.
Sorts of stuff.
So if you just want to look for latency, just make sure you're measuring latency.
Well, that's very good advice, because a lot of us would probably see how fast can I download yep. something from one machine to another.
Yep. And ping is not the way to test.
Always good to know. Well, we are learning all about proximity placement groups here on Azure Friday.